Dr. Day was highly critical of the decision by the Soufriere Comprehensive School to test the 16 students for drugs. He noted that many adults, including school officials, also consume drugs, but they are not targeted. In referring to what he described as the ineffectiveness of the tests, Dr. Day pointed out that even persons who breathe in the secondhand smoke can test positive.
Those people who tested positive, those students who tested positive down in Soufriere, could have used marijuana 2 weeks ago, could have been in a room full of marijuana. Like, let's say you live in a house where everybody smokes marijuana and the living room is always full of smoke and you're just breathing the secondhand smoke. You'll test positive. It's not an effective test, and it's definitely not a test for inebriation, right? In other words, we need a more accurate test because along with a blood alcohol test, which we don't have, that could be administered by police. So people driving under the influence of cannabis, driving under the influence of alcohol, that's a problem, you know, and that needs to be stopped.
When the young and unemployed are the only ones who become the prime target of law enforcement authorities, according to Dr. Day, they get tainted by a bad police record, which in turn inhibits their job opportunities. Dr. Day is aware of the ripple effect this can have on the youngsters in encouraging them to enter or return to a life of crime.
I would recommend that we look at cannabis as an issue that we have to deal with on a public health level according to the level of use. I mean, if somebody wakes up in the morning and smokes cannabis all day, then you might want to think about whether you have an issue or not.
According to Dr. Day, statistics indicate that well over 30,000 people in St. Lucia over the age of 18 are cannabis consumers, and this, in his view, is a very disturbing trend. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.